There are many different ways you can be counted. You can count your blessings. You can count the leaves on the shamrock. You can count the years you've lived. Grace, what else can you count by?
You can count the coins in the pockets, like a teacher tree in a church.
One pink heart.
Two pink hearts.
One yellow moon.
Two yellow moons.
Three yellow moons.
One orange star.
Two orange stars.
One blue diamond.
Two blue diamonds.
Three blue diamonds.
One green clover.
But as the leprechauns, we like to be counted by turds the most. One turd.
Two turds.
Three turds.
One and one turd.
One and two turds.
One and three turds.
Two holes.
Two and one third.
Two and two turds.
Two and three turds.
Three turds.
Three and one turd.
Lucky Charms, the best and we delicious!
Try to buy me a camel.
It'll heal anything.
See? All better.
Places to sleep in school.
By Ruby and Kaylee.
This is the main house. A beautiful creation by Ruby.
As you can see, it's modeled after a farmhouse with a tower on the left. And if you follow me towards the left, you will see this lovely pathway.
This is a beautiful watchtower to see the beautiful land we've made. It has a beautiful lake and a magnificent view. Come down and see the beautiful towers. And if you keep going, you'll see a beautiful pathway side to the benches of glory. And in the view, you'll see an amazing, magnificent architecture of Ruby the Bridge. And if you're feeling tired, you can relax in the cozy, magnificent architecture of a Japanese-style house where you'll see amazing doors and an amazing view to walk.
Hold your breath because this one is magnificent, even spectacular. It is an amazing pathway to shops, villages, all this amazing architecture made by me. Yes, I might be speaking highly, but it took an incredibly long time, and I think it's great. But it has an amazing storyline behind it of destroyers who tried to end this world.
Luckily, we managed to create and save, though it did take our class, this wonderful place that we've decided to call Kiva Town. A very funny name, as it is made completely out of Kiva planks.
Thank you. so it hasn't been an issue. Besides when I went to school.
That.
Sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Are you sure?
My feet are that yellow. You are proof? No. We're gonna be paper class. This is not even what I mean for class, but that's okay.
Oh my god, it was such a good idea to skip class.
Patricia! We've been trying to catch up with you.
Vanessa!
No, do not beneath me.
You were taking pictures of my feet.
Of her feet.
It was me.
I'm tired of you.
No one likes you.
Let's go.
Tired.
Don't take pictures of people's feet without their permission. Period.
Of all the predators in the animal kingdom, there are none more deadly than the basset hound. The basset's speed is unparalleled, and they're known to enslave humans. In fact, their only natural predators are stares. Despite their fierceness, the winter season can be a challenge for some hounds. To combat this, some develop warmer fur for the colder parts of the year. Truly Earth's deadliest animal, the basset hound takes its rightful throne as king of the animal kingdom.
Blackie's highway. I wanna ride it all night long. You're going now.
Oh, geez, what is that? Good parking. What in the world are you? What are you doing?
Are you scared?
Scared of you?
Yes. You should be scared of me.
Yeah, no, I'm not scared of you in the slightest bit, man. Sorry.
Oh, come on. You're shaking a little bit.
Yeah, no, I don't think so. I almost crashed my car. That got a little scare out of me, if that's what you're looking for.
What? That's what scared you? Almost crashing your car? I'm a giant monster, for God's sake.
Maybe if you just stood there menacingly and didn't growl, I would find you a little more threatening, but the growl just makes you look silly.
Okay, so I'm trying to get a world record for being the scariest monster ever.
You are the most unscary monster in the world.
Oh, okay. Wait, did you say in the world?
That is correct.
I am the most unscary monster in the world. That's a world record!
Wow, congratulations. Look at you. You are so good at being not good. I gotta go to work now.
Can I please get a ride to Guinness headquarters?
No, you're a giant. You can't fit.
That's okay. I'll ride on top. Sorry.
Describe to me what you feel when you walk into the school building.
Tired.
Emotional.
I'm mostly tired, but yeah, emotional. Because I just try and get through the day.
I don't want to be here.
Yeah.
Don't put that in, but.
Annoyed.
That's Girl, that's a I lie. Feel. You're always smiling.
I feel like I have some place to learn and stuff.
That was good.
At least put some effort in, girl.
Describe to me what you feel when you enter the building.
Mafia status.
I feel lit. Feel great.
Straight up.
I don't know. School, work, teachers, you know, basic stuff. School.
Panic, fear, discombobulation. It's a mix of a whole bunch of emotions, but it all boils down to fear.
I feel trapped. I feel like I have to do work that doesn't make any sense. That's pretty much it.
Describe to me what you feel when you enter the building.
When I enter this building, I feel tired. But I also feel hope and opportunity at a new day of learning.
Seeping dread pouring into my veins.
I feel absolutely nothing. Usually my brother is with me when we enter in, and usually all that I'm feeling is annoyance because he never holds the door for me.
A little bit of dread and a little bit of arousal because I know Ethan's going to be there.
Describe to me what you feel when you enter the building.
I don't know. I kind of hate it, to be honest.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's like really it.
First off, it's hot as shit. It's hot every single day. Every day. I don't know what they're doing to the AC, but
no AC at all. They cut it off.
You see, I got my pants off. It's probably like 2 degrees.
I'm sweating in the cuffer right now. I'm in the double shanty. That's why they don't like me.
That's what we got.
A lot of energy rush over. Like, it's very loud, very opening. A lot of teachers are like, shh. Yeah, and then I just go upstairs and a bunch of my friends are up here, so yeah.
Describe to me what you feel when you enter the building.
When I enter the building, it's, I don't have the happiest feelings, I don't have the sad feelings. I like to see my friends, so that does get me happy. And the teachers here are great, so I actually love coming to school sometimes.
Tired most of the time, just because it's so early. But I'm always excited to, you know, experience the school day, I guess.
Wow. is that like what you're supposed to do for the video? Am I supposed to be like...
Describe to me what you feel when you enter the building.
I don't know, bored?
I don't really feel much of anything besides, you know, just going to school.
Usually pretty annoyed.
I'm usually rushing, so I'm just stressed about something.
This is so happy as I've ever.
Describe to me how you feel when you enter the building.
I want to leave because I'm tired and don't really want to see the people I see yet so early.
Pretty happy, you know, it's a pretty good environment. Colorful floors, pretty welcoming.
Annoyance immediately. I don't know, it's school, so.
I don't know, I just feel kind of like tired probably and like anxious when I walk in the door. But I don't know if that has anything to do with the school.
I'm saying she already put down her deposit and everything.
Yeah, you have to put this.
What I feel when I enter the building is an extreme feeling of loathing and uncomfortableness.
Describe to me what you feel when you enter the building.
I want to go home.
Sorrow.
Annoyed.
Sadness.
Describe how you feel when you enter the building.
Nervous. Overwhelmed.
Describe to me what you feel when you enter the building.
Oh, that's a great question. A cross between happiness and sadness, because I love seeing all of you and it makes me happy. And I'm sad because I'm not here every day anymore.
This, the year is 2022, and the date is February 10th.
It's the 10th. Can I do this?
And this is Greenfield High School in Greenfield, Massachusetts. These are juniors Aisha here and Hannah. And I am Indy.
Hey kids, stop doing the homework, cause I got something to say.
Our prices are insane, so come on down!
Hi, welcome to News for Teens! I'm Gabe Toomey.
And I'm Gabe Cruz.
He would be the third president impeached after Andrew Johnson's impeachment in 1837 and Bill Clinton's in 1998. Welcome back to the movie reviews, folks. Today's movie review is on Terminator Dark Fate. The movie was cool. I would give it a 9 out of 10 star rating.
Hey kids, I am Iron Man. And I'm here to teach you some very important lesson and tips on what you should do during this whole coronavirus pandemic thing. Want to hear them? Come with me, and let's get started.
So the idea of this movie came on New Year's Eve when me, my mom, and my stepdad were watching one of the old Muppet movies, and then the next day my stepdad said, we're overdue for theatrically released Muppet movies, and I thought, well, it would be cool if we could make one. And he was like, sure, and I was like, wait, you're being serious? And he was like, yeah. And I'm like, oh, okay. That's right. And this is News for Teens signing off. Good night and goodbye.
All right. Tell me your name. Hey. I'm going to be the one asking questions here, buddy. Tell me. What's your favorite food? Bit of a wise guy, huh? Don't tell me what I already know. What's your major? What is your major? What do you study? Don't talk back to me. What do you think your family thinks of your lack of education? Tell me that.
All right.
You have an answer? You ever thought about that? Something wrong? Actually, I happen to know an Assassin Smith. You're looking right at him, pal. So, what do you like to do for fun? Awesome. Want to do a quick game, maybe? Well, yeah. My name is Rokiko Man. Wait, I didn't know you could talk. That's awesome, man. Why haven't you been talking the whole time? Excuse me? Anyway, as I was saying, my name is Rokiko Montoya. You killed my whole family. Prepare to die. I'm dead. Oh my god, I died. Holy crap, I'm dead. Oh my god. All this time, I thought revenge was my life's purpose. It wasn't even worth it in the end. Because now I realize I'm just as bad as he was.
End of scene.
What did you want to talk to me about?
Shh, we're being watched. Do you remember our old mafia rival, Z?
Isn't he dead?
I got a letter with only information he would know, and he's threatening to leak our emails.
Oh no, do you mean the emails about our mafia business?
Yes, here's what we're gonna do.
All right, I'm listening, Mr. President.
We're gonna fight.
Let's go!
1 second!
Are you ready, sir?
I was born ready.
So you finally arrived. It's over. I've already leaked the emails.
I suppose all good things have to come to an end at some point. Isn't that right?
Thank you.
Have you ever been held prisoner, but the chair they tied you to was bad for your back and just plain uncomfortable? Well, tell them to come on down to Rayman Shenanigans.
Rayman Shenanigans. Chair so good, Stockholm Syndrome kicks in early.
Cut!
Oh, I'm recording. Okay. Ugh. This is my expose of Gianni Iggy Ignatius. You know, when I first started thinking about this, I said, that's one sketchy fella, and I'm gonna take him down. For the next few weeks, you will be following me on my journey of me gonna expose Iggy for being a real, in legal terms, jerk. I know something's going on. I'm gonna find out. Come with me.
Are you ready for this? Okay, yeah. The 8 large tentacles surround the ship. Me and the boys hoisted the masts and loaded the cannons in hopes of salvation. The captain was prepared to meet his watery grave, ready to go down with the ship. But we were ready to put up a fight. This isn't like it was in all of the Moby Dick. We are real-life sailors, and this Kraken could end our lives. But this God has willed it, so we must die today. We cannot fail such a beautiful, majestic creature. For even if we tried, we probably wouldn't be able to. I know I did a full 360 here and changed my opinion on whether or not I'm going to fight back against this huge, evil creature, but that's part of the thought process. We're capturing everything. It's going in, baby.
Clean, 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 must 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 clean, 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 clean.
Could you just start and tell us your name?
My name is Andrew.
Lucille.
Tama.
Brayden.
Brayden, do you know why you're here today?
Is this like...
I do remember one night in 2019, we all lost power and a couple people went missing.
Oh yeah, I remember. I was in my backyard playing with my hedgehog and there was a bright beam of light and I looked up and I ran back inside because I thought I was going to get abducted.
I don't know very much about the occurrence. I just know it was very odd and he went missing for a couple of days.
Who went missing, Brayden?
Mr. Wolfnard.
Yeah, there was this interesting teacher that I got. His name was Mr. Wolfnard. He's a little odd, but yeah, I remember that. Some weird stuff. Some rumors saying that he's possibly abducted by aliens. I think he's a pretty interesting guy. Kind of quirky. I think that he does some weird stuff, like stare at vents and...
I've noticed weird staring and him talking to vents.
Where is he?
Can't really make good eye contact with people.
He kind of reminds me of that lizard from the Monsters, Inc. movie. He, like, won't look at you in the eye, and then when he does, he feels like he's staring into your soul.
He had a full-grown beard and, you know, like a normal film class teacher. And 10th grade year, we walked into school, and he's looking 10 years younger. No beard, no facial hair. Surprised me, shocked me how a person can change so quickly.
He seemed to talk about things that weren't really on topic a lot, and he would just tell us about himself, and...
I really like using that for recording my chickens. I think it really picks up all of their clucks and their murmurs with grace and aplomb. It's quite nice.
Mr. Wolfnard, what does this have to do with film?
It didn't seem very human-like.
I think a lot of the students think he's pretty weird.
I would just like to tell you, we need to keep an eye on him. He doesn't seem normal.
Brayden, do you believe in aliens?
No.
I do. I personally do, yeah.
Yes, 100%.
Yes, I do believe in aliens.
Okay.
Hey, is this where I sit?
Yeah.
Okay. Sure. My name is Bernie Wolfnard, and I'm 35 years old, and I'm a teacher here at this high school. I'm not really sure what you mean by strange occurrence of 2019. No?
Are you sure?
Yes. I mean, we would know if there's aliens here.
Yeah.
Right?
Like, is your memory...
I'm sorry, could you repeat the question? No, they must be mistaken. What? You said you have video of that?
Possibly.
Oh, I think that time there was, like, a weird smell coming from it. And, sometimes I just, like, curse a lot under my breath. So I think I was, like, trying to figure out what that weird smell was and just, like, maybe cursing to myself.
So you were talking to the smell?
No, I was talking to myself.
Okay.
Just normal air sounds and smell sounds. Not that I recall. Yeah, I'm sure. Moment of our birth. There's aliens in our midst.
Talking to you about the thing.
Yeah, right?
No!
Dude. What?
My stretch is so good. I'll beat you.
Your stretch
the next
is so
three
good.
Moves.
So
next
good.
Three moves, I promise.
Uh-huh.
Wait, this is yours?
Oh, Tom, you really gotta get the downstrokes just like this.
That's what I've been doing.
Try.
Here, let me try it. Okay,
yeah.
That looks way better.
Yeah, way better.
I was meaning to talk to you about something, though.
What?
So, you know this heist. I think the boss is
gonna keep all the money for himself.
What?
Yeah.
He would never.
See,
I trust that man.
I don't. So you know what I'm thinking?
What?
Me and you? Take it all for ourselves.
How would we do that?
I have a plan. So you want to do like 60-40?
60-40?
Yeah.
Young man, you are bugging.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and check that guy out right there. This is what's going on here. You gotta make this guy. Don't touch him yet.
That's smart.
That guy's got some moves.
I know, it was awesome. The layout he had was really good.
Check out. I don't think you want to do that one. Though watch out. That's what his opponent, Maddie Mosher, did. She got screwed up.
Okay.
Hey, hold on a second. Where's Tom? Are we waiting for him or what?
I haven't seen him today.
Rob, weren't you with him yesterday? Have you talked to him?
The last time I talked to him was like yesterday when we were brushing our hair together in the dressing room. We got him. I think he just had a lot of history homework.
I don't know, that seems kind of sus. Like, should we be worried that people are disappearing?
People are not disappearing. He just had a lot of history homework, and his dad got him about that, or talked to him.
I have a bad feeling about this.
Me too.
I really need to go to the store, guys. Does anyone want to come with me after school later?
Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god.
How are we doing this? Is this
what are we doing?
Oh my god.
Are we really in ninth grade?
Oh my god, we can't do this.
They are too
so they have a meltdown.
This is too much.
This is too much.
This is a lot.
We can't do this. It's
more way too
much. We have a meltdown.
And I think I wrote it off in my mind. Keith used to reach the church to the only option now. Sydney and everyone had not need to work for us samples. Okay. We blew against the labor strip of August 1963. The Hurricanes and Cobbles. Blew the years. The hands of our hands. That's right. Christmas log. Sarah Severin. Oh, we met one show that I'm not here ever asked the monsters. Well, we would find fun. People would say, I'm sure I'll let us have one. I guess the line of house on the road. There are the power people work in you. You'll not take the batteries to him, but he's about to look out.
Yeah, I've been to the cafeteria. We've got a stupid flavor wrong.
You went with scientists? I thought we were going with auto mechanic.
I thought we were going with scientists.
But where's the lockpick?
I don't know. I guess he couldn't make it.
Open anyway.
Whoa, there it is. Let's go.
It's happening. Tell me when. It's just sitting here.
Just like that?
I think so.
I think you just take it.
I was asleep.
You left me in the dumpster for dead. I thought we were friends, man.
My bad.
Dude, I can't believe we did that. That was like a lot easier than I thought it was gonna be. Hey, Big Mac!
Mr. Wolfnard!
Fine. It's fine.